Bye, Noodles. See you when I get back.
Bye.
I got my bag packed and I am going to Toronto.
For people who aren't musicians, there's a magic to music and to what makes what sound or why these sounds work together. I'm kind of coming at music from this place that I just really love all of it. And even beyond that, I just love sounds. I'm excited by new sounds. I'm excited when I hear something and I'm not sure how it was created. Hey, it's Andrew Huang.
Hey there, it's Nat. And for those of you who aren't already fans of Andrew Huang, he is an amazing, prolific, experimental musician and YouTuber who I love watching and listening to. He's created more than 2,000 songs and is known for using the sounds from non-musical objects in a musical way.
I like to explore every different facet of music and help people understand it, as well as show my process when I'm creating stuff.
I've seen Andrew make music with skateboards, modular synthesizers, radiators, and a unicorn, and that got me wondering, what kind of music could he make with machine learning? Google has a research project called Magenta, which stands for Music and Art Generation, and is all about using machine learning to create new kinds of artistic tools. Among them, NSynth, short for neural synthesizer. This prototype totally drew Andrew's interest when I approached him, and he proposed creating a song entirely using NSynth-generated sounds. To learn more about how NSynth works, I spoke with one of its researchers, Jesse.
I feel like a lot of machine learning is somewhat usually put into a reductive context. Usually it's like I have a complicated thing like an image, and I give you a simple thing like a label about what's in the image. Neural networks are just starting to be used in an expansive way, you know, going from simple to complex. And I think that has a lot of really fun potential.
Synthesizers have had an enormous impact on music. Probably no instrument is as versatile. From the ability to model acoustic instruments like violins and trumpets, to the generation of otherworldly sounds that sparked new genres. Synthesizers do this by manipulating and combining the fundamental qualities of a sound into new forms.
And so NSynth was kind of just a step along that trajectory. We curated a large data set of sounds, 1,000 different instruments and 300,000 different individual notes, and then use neural networks to sort of discover the latent structure within those sounds, actually drawing the waveform one sample at a time. What's interesting about sound is that you can represent it as numbers. What happens when a sound wave moves past the microphone is that the elements move back and forth, and it records that as a voltage, and those are just a series of numbers going up and down.
Traditionally, to mix two sounds, say the sound of a flute and the sound of a cat, you would add the numbers at each point along each sound wave, which sounds like a cat meowing along with a flute. But NSynth takes a very different, much more mathematically intensive and abstract approach.
So what we do is we take those numbers, we run it through a bunch of layers of computation, and then we scrunch it down, so we compress it. The network can't exactly reproduce the original sound, but it does its best. And in doing so, it has to pick out what are the most useful features of the sound and store those as another series of numbers, what we call a latent vector. And so if you add the numbers from the latent vectors together, instead of getting two separate sounds, then you get sort of a flute that meows.
This is not just a combination of the original cat and flute audio files. It's NSynth completely reinterpreting them based on its knowledge of all these different musical instruments and notes that it was trained on.
It's mixing the features rather than mixing in the actual audio form itself.
When you heard the first results, what was your reaction?
I mean, I think my first reaction was awesome. You know, even the first results all sounded incredibly awful. They sounded like, you know, just
but
like
awesome.
Buzzing and hisses and everything, but it's just, It just felt so fun to me that, you know, you could just take a bunch of math and a bunch of ideas you have, and then you create this thing that has a unique character to it. I would just be sitting coding and like listening on my headphones, and I would just start laughing, and everyone around me would just thought I was crazy.
To get started on his song, Andrew first needed to gather up a bunch of sounds for NSynth to process. And to make things a little bit more fun and unpredictable, he asked his audience to send him short sound clips.
Anything from something that someone just recorded on their phone that they, you know, did in their kitchen.
Yay!
Oh, yeah.
We got a couple submissions from people who played an instrument. One that stood out to me was someone sent in a monster sound effect that they had designed for a short film that they were working on. And then I had also picked out a few sounds that I have created for my own sample libraries that I was just interested to see what would happen.
After Jesse processed these roughly 200 sounds through NSynth, he sent Andrew back close to 9,000 new sounds.
Here's the original. Here it is crossed with a synthesizer note. With that falsetto voice.
So that sounds more guitar.
Yeah, yeah, it does. So that guitar type sound came in handy a lot just to give this a bit of a sonic signature.
Yeah.
What I'm noticing now is all these guitar-like sounds actually come from really different sound sources. So we've got like a bass note crossed with someone saying, haha, yes. And a bass sound crossed with someone doing a weird mouth sound. I think that was like a pop sort of. And then creaky voice crossed with falsetto. A clap crossed with someone saying, oh yeah.
If I know that it's oh yeah, I can kinda hear it. But
and
yeah.
I wonder if, oh, I chopped off the O, so. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So this was one of my favorite sounds. It's the 3D printer crossed with a stylophone, but I feel like it ends up sounding something in between a person screaming and a guitar wailing, or maybe a whale, I don't know. but I just really like that sound, and I kind of based the rest of this track on that accent, just because I felt like it was really unique. It was kind of a surprise for me. Of all the sounds I heard, there were a lot of great ones, but that one stood out as something that was particularly different from other stuff that I've worked with or heard before. There's like a uniqueness to it, and then also all the sounds are sort of, they become this little family unit that share a lot of characteristics.
What would be the name of the family? Like, what are the adjectives that like describe this NSynth family of sounds?
They are harsh, textured. They're very dynamic. Some of them really kind of abruptly shift, even within one sample. But harsh is definitely the first thing that comes to mind. I think once I heard the sounds, I felt like I just wanted to showcase them as much as I could, shape them into something that might be a little more traditional sounding or a little poppier or something I could sing over. I thought it would be more interesting to focus on what was unique about these sounds.
One of the most interesting things to me about NSynth is that, yes, it is this machine learning algorithm, and it's kind of easy to hear machine and think, oh, it's going to be perfect. But it's actually its imperfections that give it its unique character, its unique sounds, its unique tones. And the way that Andrew was able to exploit some of these characteristics about it even more and really draw out these imperfections created some of the most unique sounds that it generated.
How do these tools change the dynamic between an artist and their instruments?
It feels very radical, but in a sense, it's very not radical. The earliest flutes, like bone flutes, were actually older than like stone pottery. So the flute is older than soup. You know, like our ability to express ourselves musically has always been intertwined with the tools that we can use.
Being able to whisper above an orchestra was only possible after, you know, a microphone came into play, or if we had recordings that we could mix. Using computers to sequence music, we can play faster than a human could play. I'm curious to see if these kinds of AI developments go further, like what will that add to the equation?
Do you think that you'll make music with machine learning, whatever tools in the future after this?
I think I absolutely will, yeah. I'm so interested in that element of surprise. And I think that it's opening up an entirely new way to explore and experience music. So I'm very interested to see where it goes.
Thanks for watching. Now, if you haven't already, go check out Andrew's video where you can hear the full song that he made. There's a link in the description and on top of this video right now. And also in the description are a bunch of different NSynth and Magenta related links if there's something you want to learn more about or try a demo yourself. All right, bye from me for today.